the IRAs is the way to go.
Yeah, and an IRA is one of the most popular vehicles out there right now. You know, traditionally, most people are used to just buying stocks, bonds, or mutual funds. But those are not the only investments that IRAs can actually hold. Self-directed IRAs are what they're called. They're accounts that can actually own rental real estate. Like, it can own a duplex down the street. It could be invested in a small business in your community. And so these are assets that retirement accounts can actually own. You got to learn the rules on it. It's a little tricky. But for those that want to invest the time and invest in assets they know and can see, a self-directed IRA could be a good option for someone to take a portion of their retirement account and look to invest it. Again, it's a way to diversify from being totally invested just in the stock market.
Start opportunity shifting. Shift some of your ideas into a tax-free scenario, like a Roth IRA or a health savings account. I have a health savings account that owns a rental property. I love to try to invest in things that I enjoy and I know are going to make money outside of the stock market.
Yeah, health savings account that owns a rental property.
That's right. Well, you can self-direct your retirement accounts. And we love directed IRA. It's a custodian, much like a stockbroker you would think of. It's a trust company where you can invest your IRAs, your 401ks, Coverdells, SEPs, and a health savings account in what you know best. So if you know real estate, why not take your retirement account and invest it in real estate? And your stockbroker doesn't tell you this. They don't want you to self-direct.
Yeah.
But you can take control of your retirement and invest it in tax-free ways. So a great way to save taxes is to create tax-free income in the first place.
Mark Kohler, thank you.
Doesn't the law say I can't do this? Let's talk about the law first. The only restrictions on investments you can buy with your IRA include life insurance, collectibles, and S-corporation stock. There's no restriction on real estate or private companies. What's happened though is that the companies that provide retirement accounts are typically brokerages. What do brokers sell? Financial products. Now I know what you're thinking. I've never heard of this. How come I've never heard of this? I called my broker at Merrill Lynch and they said I can't do it. That's not because your IRA cannot own real estate. That's because your IRA at Merrill Lynch won't let you buy real estate. It's a restriction that financial institutions place on their accounts. So the first thing you're gonna need to do is move your account from your broker over to a self-directed IRA custodian, like our company Directed IRA, who will let you invest in real estate, private companies, or other alternative assets with your IRA funds. Now, the second thing to know is really cool, because the same tax benefits you get when you buy stock with your IRA apply when you buy real estate or private companies with your IRA. So if I bought Facebook stock for $100 a share and I sold it for $150 in my IRA, one of the great perks is that gain goes back into my retirement account, no taxes, right? It's building up tax-free in a Roth or tax-deferred in a traditional. With a self-directed IRA, it works the same way for real estate or private assets. If I bought a property for $100,000 with my IRA, I sold it for $150,000, that $50,000 gain goes back into my IRA, and I pay no tax on the gain. It's either tax-free in a Roth or it's coming out tax-deferred in my traditional. So I get that same tax perk in a self-directed IRA that I'd get at my brokerage IRA buying stocks and mutual funds. There's a couple things you want to know when you're self-directing your IRA. First, these need to be investment assets. If you're buying real estate, you're buying it for investment purposes, like a rental property or maybe a property you're gonna flip. You can even be investing in an LLC that owns a partnership that owns a bigger property or portfolio of assets. Maybe it's a private company, it's a startup, it's a private equity fund or other private investment. Those are all acceptable assets for an IRA. What you can't do though is buy assets to benefit yourself. You can't buy a piece of real estate you're gonna go live in or that your kids or other family members are gonna live in. These are investment assets, not assets for personal use. The last thing I want to say on this is self-directed IRAs let you invest in assets you know best. If you know real estate, why are you buying mutual funds with your retirement account? Why don't you invest in real estate? If you have a specialty in private equity or tech, why are you investing in big publicly traded companies when you could be investing in startups or other venture companies?